Madam Speaker, House Resolution 461 provides for the creation of a select investigative panel of the Committee on Energy and Commerce. The resolution ensures the House exercises one of its most fundamental constitutional responsibilities, oversight of the use of federal funds and compliance with federal law. Undercover investigations have revealed that an organization that receives hundreds of millions of taxpayer dollars annually, Planned Parenthood, has also been taking the remains of unborn children and selling them to tissue collection firms. Its staff has reportedly even altered their medical procedures to more effectively dismember unborn children, with one abortionist saying that, quote, "We've been very good at getting heart, lung, liver, because we know that, so I'm not going to crush that part. I'm going to basically crush below. I'm going to crush above, and I'm going to see if I can get it all intact," end quote. There are also allegations that children may have been born alive and left to die in order to harvest their tissue. How can we in Congress ignore these charges? It is clear that a full investigation is not only warranted, but imperative into these issues. Even if these abortion providers somehow manage to comply with all federal laws while dismembering children, it's clear we need to learn more about their barbaric tactics so we can amend those laws and ensure practices like these never happen again, particularly by organizations receiving millions from U.S. taxpayers. Madam Speaker, in order to effectively continue the oversight that the House has begun into these issues, House Resolution 461 would establish a select investigative panel at the Committee on Energy and Commerce to provide a full investigation and study into these allegations. This panel would be made up of 13 members appointed by the Speaker, five of which will be by the recommendation of the Minority Leader and chaired by a member of the Energy and Commerce Committee. Its operations will not require any additional appropriations of funds. The investigation will be focused on medical procedures and business practices of entities involved in fetal tissue procurement, federal funding and support for abortion providers, practices of providers of second and third trimester abortions, including partial birth abortions, medical care provided to children born alive as a result of an attempted abortion, and necessary changes in law or regulation identified by this investigation. This type of investigation or special panel is far from unprecedented. When in the majority, my colleagues across the aisle formed the Select Intelligence Oversight Panel under the Appropriations Committee, as well as a Select Committee on Energy and Independence and Global Warming. The creation of a select investigative panel on the issues surrounding the sale of unborn children's tissue is clearly within precedent, and I hope members on both sides of the aisle will agree that we must get to the bottom of this. We've seen video evidence of children being dismembered to facilitate the sale of their hearts and other organs. Few issues can make us come together like our children, and it is my hope that our partisan battles will cease for a brief moment to enable us to have a full investigation into the fate of children at the most vulnerable time of their lives. Even for those who support abortion on demand, it should be simple to unite behind the principle that organizations receiving hundreds of millions in taxpayer funds are subject to congressional oversight, particularly when their divisive practices may violate federal law and are frankly barbaric. I urge my colleagues to support this resolution.